हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक प्रेगनेंसी एंड एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट। सो इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट इम्प्लांटेशन। सो व्हाट इज इम्प्लांटेशन? इम्प्लांटेशन मीन्स द अटैचमेंट ऑफ द ब्लास्टोसिस्ट इन द एंडोमेट्रियम लाइनिंग ऑफ यूट्रस। सो आफ्टर दैट देयर विल बी द सम चेंजेस टेक्स प्लेस इन दिस ब्लास्टोसिस्ट एंड दैट इज नोन एज द प्रेगनेंसी एंड द एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट। सो दैट इज द डायग्राम ऑफ द ब्लास्टोसिस्ट एंड हैविंग द इनर सेल मास ऑल्सो इन साइड इट। सो आफ्टर सम टाइम द ड्रोपोब्लास्ट ऑफ द दिस ब्लास्टोसिस्ट दैट गिव राइज टू द फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस एंड दीज फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस आर नोन एज कॉरियोनिक विलाई एंड दीज कॉरियोनिक विलाई शो इंटर डिजिटेशन बिटवीन द एंडोमीट्रियम लाइनिंग। इंटर डिजिटेशन मीन्स सपोज दीज आर द कॉरियोनिक विलाई एंड द एंडोमीट्रियम लाइनिंग ऑल्सो शो द कनेक्शन बिटवीन दीज। सो इट इज नोन एज द इंटर डिजिटेशन। So these chorionic villi along with the endometrium lining of the uterus show interdigitation and the maternal blood is also there, so that make a disc like structure known as placenta. So here you can see that is the tropoblast, inner cell mass is there, and that these are the chorionic villi, here the endometrium lining of the uterus, and it is the maternal blood. So the tissue and the chorionic villi, the endometrium tissue and the chorionic villi show interdigitation like this. Means suppose these are the chorionic villi and that is the endometrium lining, so like this the interdigitation is done and that is known as the placenta. So this placenta, it work like an endocrine tissue and also help in the transport of the food, oxygen and nutrients, and the embryo can remove its waste product like carbon dioxide through placenta. So what is the function of placenta? So the embryo get its food like glucose, oxygen and other nutrients, and it can remove its waste through placenta. Second, the placenta also known as the endocrine tissue. So what is the meaning of endocrine? Endocrine means if it is secreting the hormones, there are the endocrine tissue, that is the endocrine tissue. So if it is secreting the hormone, then we can say it is the endocrine tissue. And here, what are the different hormones? Estrogen, progesterone, HCG, HPL and the relaxin, human chorionic gonadotrophic hormone, human placental lactogen hormone and the relaxin. So these hormones are secreted by the placenta. So this question always comes that what are the different hormones that are only during the pregnancy, that are secreted only during the pregnancy. So these are the three hormones, HCG, HPL and relaxin. These three hormones are only produced in the human female during the pregnancy. So relaxin, that is released by the ovary in the later stage, and this estrogen and progesterone, these are also secreted. So we can say in a pregnant woman there will be the so many hormones are secreted, and these hormones are essential for the proper growth of the developing embryo. So except these, the high amount of cortisol, the high amount of prolactin and high amount of thyroxine is also present in the mother blood. So cortisol, that is released from the adrenal gland, prolactin hormone is there, that is released from the pituitary, thyroxine from the thyroid gland. So thyroid gland, that is very essential for the metabolic function of the developing embryo. So these are the different hormones that are released by placenta, and so this placenta also known as the endocrine tissue. So after that, the inner cell mass are there, and these inner cell mass that give rise to the embryo, and these inner cell mass give rise to ectoderm, the outer layer, endoderm, the inner layer, and in between the mesoderm layer is also formed, and this mesoderm layer is present in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Ectoderm, endoderm and the mesoderm. So these different layers make the different organs in the developing embryo. So inside the, you can say the, these inner cell mass, some stem cells are also present. So what are the stem cells? Stem cells are the special types of cells which have the property to make any cells of our body. So these stem cells are also present in the inner cell mass. And these are present in the placenta and the umbilical cord of the developing embryo. And you have heard in the advertisement that after the delivery of the child, there is the cryopreservation of the human placenta. Why? Because in the human placenta, these stem cells are present. And so what is the use of these stem cells? So these stem cells have the property to develop any organ of the body. So if the developing child after the birth, if in the future there will be the any problem along with the child that the organ is not functioning well, then these stem cells can develop the any organ of that child. So that is the use of these stem cells. After that we can understand here the cross-section of the uterus, and you can see the different parts here. So that is the cavity of the uterus, and here these finger like projections known as the villi. These are the placental villi, the these chorionic villi and the endometrium lining show interdigitation known as placenta. So the uterine cavity is there and the developing embryo, and here the yolk sac is also present. Yolk sac means initially the formation of the RBCs, that is done by the yolk sac of the embryo. So that is very important, the formation of RBCs, that is done by the yolk sac. So inside this there will be the pregnancy there, and the gestation period is here, and that gestation period is of 9 months. So let us discuss what are the different changes takes place during the 9 months of pregnancy. We all are aware about that the gestation period in case of human baby is that is the 9 months, and these are divided into 3 trimester. So what is the meaning of trimester? Trimester means it is of 3 months. So first 3 months that are in the first trimester, next 3 months, 4th, 5th and 6th, second trimester, and the 7th, 8th and 9th, that is the third trimester. So in the first trimester, you can say the first month of the pregnancy, there will be the you can say the heart sound we can hear with the help of the stethoscope. So in the first month the heart sound we can hear, and by the end of the second month of the pregnancy the fetus develop limbs and digits. And by the end of the 12 weeks, the first trimester, you can say most of the major organs are formed. For example, limbs, external genitalia and other organs are developed. And the first movement of the fetus and the appearance of the hair on the head, that is observed during the 5th month of the pregnancy. And after that the body is covered with the fine hairs, eyelids and eyelashes are formed at the end of the 6th month, and in the 9th month the baby is fully developed. So that is the different changes takes place during the 9 months of the pregnancy. So we discussed the pregnancy and the embryonic development. So during the pregnancy the different hormones are released by the placenta. What is placenta? It is a disc-like structure which is formed by the interdigitation of chorionic villi and the endometrium lining of the uterus, and it work like the endocrine tissue and also help in transport. And these inner cell mass, these give rise to the embryo, and ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderms are there. These different layers form the different organ in the developing embryo, and inside the, means in the side of the these inner cell stem cells also there. These stem cells can give rise to any organ of our body. Here you can see the uterus, and inside the uterus the yolk sac, placenta or the uterine cavity, developing embryo. This developing embryo take almost 9 months during its development, and it is divided into the three trimester, first, second and third. So what are the different parts are developed during these three trimester, and what are the different hormones which are present only during the pregnancy or only in the pregnant ladies. I think you all understood this thing. So thank you.